Welcome to Dead by Daylight's latest PTB for Chapter 28, In Transmission. Today we're going to be checking out the new survivor, the brand new killer, and the brand new map. So let's dive on in. Alright everybody, welcome to In Transmission. Today is a great day for this PTB. Let's check out the survivor, who is the one, the only Gabriel Soma. There you go, right there. And if we go to his info, we can check out his perks. We have Troubleshoot, where if you're chased by the killer, the perk activates. You see the aura of the generator with the most progress, and you see the aura of the killer for 6 seconds after dropping a pallet. The effect lasts for 10 seconds, then it deactivates. Okay. We have May for this. You run 3% faster. After you finish healing, another survivor gain the endurance status effect for 10 seconds. Finally, we have Scavenger. When holding an empty toolbox, Scavenger activates. Succeeding a grayscale check will repairing gains one token up to four. When you reach maximum tokens, lose all tokens and automatically recharge the toolbox to full. Sorry, I had to move my camera, but look what he's got right there. What the heck is that? Some sort of scanner. Some sort of scanner of what sort, but I had to move the camera away just so you guys can look at his face and whatnot. Pretty interesting stuff. I love the idea of the sci-fi genre coming into the game. Let's check out the killer, the Singularity. He is right over here. Amazing. His power is called Quantum Institution. Which, if you saw the anniversary, it's basically he has the ability to launch biopods. And you can transfer your camera onto the biopods and track them. And once you shoot them, they get infected. Which over time is going to make survivors want to cleanse them, which they can do with a special interaction called EMP, which is basically just a bunch of chests all throughout the map. They grab them, and they can use the EMP to get rid of the corruption or the biopods that are spread throughout. Let's check out the perks. We have genetic limits. When a survivor finishes healing, they suffer from the exhaustion status effect. We have forced instation. We have forced instation. When a survivor is put into the dying state by any means, all the survivors standing within 16 meters in range, they suffer from the hindrance status effect for 10 seconds, reduce movement speed by 15%. Perk goes into cooldown. Then we have machine learning. After performing a damage generator action, perk activates. While this perk is active, the next generator you damage will be compromised until it's complete. The generator is highlighted in yellow. When the compromised generator is complete, you become undetectable and gain 7% haste for 30 seconds. Then the perk deactivates. If you damage another generator while another generator is compromised, the compromised generator becomes the latest one damaged. Alright, how about we go through a brief look at the add-ons for the Singularity, and then we'll get into a game. All right, so for this first game, we're going to run all three of the Singularity's perks and also Jolt. And then we're going to run the Nutritional Slurry for two extra biopods and Android Arm. For the Slipstream infection range between survivors needs increased by 2 meters. Bring in the Ebony Mori. Do a custom game. Get into the map, which I believe is called Toba Landing. And we can check out that Mori as well. All right, we're here at Toba Landing. Looks like he's ready for action. These are the crates of where the EMPs are at, by the way. I'm very concerned this is going to be a Garden of Joy sequel. Gotta launch a pod right there. You can chase this out. Is this Shaq? Okay. So we just infected her. Catcher here. All right, let's check out the pallet break. There's a hook right here. Pod right there. They're not running any perks, so where did he go? Should we check out main building? Let's do it. We'll put a pod in there. Is this main building? Oh my god, what are you? Patty, what are you doing? Is there a way you can get rid of the pods? I don't think there is. You know what? We'll go up to a pod and see. Can't get rid of it. Okay. There you go. I want to launch some pods, so okay, yeah, so this is being worked on. Where is that one? It's over here. There you are. Ah! The controls are a little bit weird. I'm not really showcasing my power. Oh my god, she has an EMP. That's what the EMPs are. Alright, they must have, they must have got rid of the one on top. Oh. Alright, can we put our power on that? Let's check out another biopod. If we get Yunjin Lia, we can see the Mori. I want to lock on her. Oh my god. Wait, she got it, she got it. Okay. Let's get out of this. This one's being worked on. Injured Yui. Let's see. Oh, come on. I want to be able to track him, so he's running all the way to the corner. I got her. Did she just pop it? All right, it's Mori time. Let's go.
It will be fast, possibly painless.
What?
Die fast, please.
Oh my God.
It is over.
Wait, we're gonna have to look at that at the killer shack. We're gonna have to reset these pods. Oh, hello. Alright, let's break this. Why can't I track her? Yui. Hello, Hattie. Oh, it's Mori time. Let's go into the killer shack. Okay, here we go.
It will be fast, possibly painless. Die fast, please. It is almost over.
Oh, her face! Am I allowed to show that? Why can't I, why can't I shoot it? Dude, you can blend in with this place so much. It's just very difficult to control the power. Oh, I see her. Where was that? I feel like he runs a little bit slower. Main building chase? Oh, there's basement. There we go. Well, we finished the game. Okay.
It will be fast, possibly painless. Please. It is almost over.
Oh. That is disgusting. That's the most disgusting Mori I've seen. GG's. Oh my god. Well, guys, hope you enjoyed this gameplay. If you like what you see, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe down below. I'll be playing this live on Twitch the moment the video goes live, so go check me out. Until then, I'm going to edit this, and hope you all have a great day.